So, important states of NFA. A state of an NFA is important if it has non-epsilon outgoing transition. There is some transition which is led by some input symbol. Okay, then it is definitely an important state. So notice that the subset construction uses only important state in the in a set T when it computes epsilon closure move TA. Okay, the set of states reachable from T on an input T. Understand? No, sorry, on an input A. The set of states moves S comma A is a non-empty only if state S is important. During the subset construction, two sets of NFA states can be identified, treated as they were in the same set if they have the same important state and either both have accepting states or neither does accept. Okay. Then the only important state are those introduced as initial states in the basis part for a particular symbol position in the regular expression. Each important state corresponding to a particular operand in the regular expression. Here, operands are what you have concatenation operation and you have star operation. Okay. The constructed NFA has only one accepting state, but this state have no outgoing transition. Is not an important state. Okay. So by concatenating a unique right-hand marks this given by hash to a regular expression R, we give accepting state for for R a transition on hash. That means if you we add hash, that if you are getting a transition to hash, then we say that it is accepted. Okay, making it an important state for NFA R hash. Why? Because well, what we are saying that important state are those states which are having some outgoing transition for some symbol A belongs to the input symbol sigma. But if you think about a final state in NFA, it may not have any outgoing state. Then you will say, oh, this is not an important state, but this is an important state. How we can do this? We just do augment the R with a hash and we add one transition from the final state to hash to make it final state, sorry, important state. So augmented regular expression is looks like this. I have already told you. So when the construction is complete, any state with a transition on hash must be an accepting state. Now the concept of nodes. Okay, so the same tree you have seen with R1, R2, R3 was writing. Okay, now the important state of the NFA correspond directly to the position in the regular expression that holds symbols. Now present the regular expression by its syntax tree first. Okay, so our regular expression what we had was A or B whole star A B B. Right? So what it is saying that you give position number to each of this regular expression is each of the symbol in the regular expression. So if I give this A gets the first position 1, B gets second position 2, A gets 3, this B fourth position, this B is at fifth position. Now we have to augment it. So this hash is going to be added it is going to get the sixth position. Okay. Now, if we construct a syntax tree without using this sub-regular expression, then what will happen? We'll use, see, what are the what we have, operators here, this OR operator is here, this OR operator is here, we have this star here, we have concatenation here, we have concatenation here, and concatenation here, right? So let the correspond to the operands and interior nodes correspond to the operators. So we have, these are the operators we have. So dot is the cat node operator for cat node, or is or node operator, and star node is star. Okay, so these operators always will get in the node position or intermediate node position, and these symbols, which symbols belongs to sigma, in this case A and B, will be always on the leaf. Okay, now if you construct a regular expression, sorry, a syntax tree for this regular expression A or B for star A B B hash, then we take this part first, A or B. Okay, this is position number of this A, and this position number of this B. Okay, then we have a star, and under this star, only one node is there, that is this OR node. So star came here. Then we have a concatenation node here. I had shown this concatenation node. This concatenates it between this result of star, whatever you have, that substring with one A. This A is having position number 3 here. Okay, so this concatenation node. Then another concatenation node we get here, okay, which concatenates this part with this B, which is position number is 4, this B is having position number of 4, okay. Then we get another concatenation node, which concatenates this part with this B, okay, which this B is having position number 5, okay, position number 5. And finally, we have another concatenation node, which concatenates this part with hash. Okay, hash is having position number 6 in the regular expression. So I think up to this, it is clear to all. Okay. So this is the way how you will approach, or you will follow, to convert a given regular expression to a syntax tree like this. Okay, now it is the same thing, syntax tree for the given regular expression. In fresh way, it is just shown to you. Okay, now come to the point. Leaves in the syntax tree are labeled by epsilon or by any alphabet symbols. Yes, here in this case, all the leaves are alphabet symbols, but there is no epsilon. To each leaf not labeled epsilon, attach a unique integer. So this unique integer is nothing but the position number. The position of the leaf, and also as the position of the symbol. Okay. So a symbol can have several positions, one and three. Like you can see, A is a symbol. It is having, it is appearing in position number 1, as well as a position number 3. B is appearing in position number 2. It is appearing in 4 and 5. So these position numbers are also helping you to distinguish different appearance of same symbol in different places. Isn't it? Now, the position in the syntax tree correspond to the important states of the constructed NFA. Okay. Now look at this. Previously, for this regular expression, when it was not augmented, we had only this part. We had constructed this regular expression. Sorry, this NFA. Okay, but when we got some augmentation, we added this here and there. First thing to note. Okay, another thing you can note here. Some of the states are named by alphabets, and you know, some of the states are named by number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And here you can see A, B, E, C, D. Okay, these are given by capital alphabets. Right, so what it is showing is the important state and unimportant state. Okay, so NFA with important state number and other state are represented by letter. So you can see the important states are given by number. This one is important state, two is an important state, so it is given number by number. 3, 4, 5, 6 are important state. Yeah. I think it is clear to you, right? Okay. So you can see here, this 0 is corresponds to this A, then this 1 is become this B, right? And this 2 here became this 1. And 4 is 2, 3 is C, and so on, right? And the remaining part you can understand. Okay, and this is added due to this hash. Now, function computed from